So that was, I think, a fundamentally different idea that wasn't, people had talked about building a semantic web, but it didn't have that idea. People had talked about building semantic networks, but it didn't have that idea. But that idea was, I think, the thing that made it work. So I started building it first for the intelligence agencies as a way to get them to organize their information. But, you know, when I realized they really, you know, weren't going to get it together to do that, I just started building it, you know, myself for this education project, which didn't really have money for it. But it was an audacious enough idea to sort of capture all the knowledge of the world that we managed to get venture capital funding for it. And so I started a company originally with people like Robert Cook and Kurt Bollacker, and we started building this, and we realized we needed better engineering. And I didn't really want to explain to people what we were doing because it was still kind of in the stealth stage, but I wanted to find if there was other people that would be interested in this. So I made a kind of an abstract drawing of sort of conceptually what would be a great goal. And I just showed it up in a whole bunch of slides. I was showing pictures of robots at some O'Reilly conference. And it was just kind of a troll, really, to see if anybody would pick up on it. And nobody at the conference picked up on it. So I thought, man, that was a failure. But then I got this call from this guy, John Giannandrea, who was a fantastic person who had been one of the early people at Netscape, who said, hey, I noticed you had this slide in your talk. I was wondering if you meant this by it. And he had like the whole concept, and he saw what was important about it. And I was like, yes. It's like, why don't you come join us? So he turned out actually to be the key person that really put it together and made it work. And so we built this thing and started putting knowledge into it. We made it all free. In fact, we tried to come up with a name. We called it MetaWeb at first because it was sort of information that was about the stuff that was on the web initially. And that was the name of the company. But then we began to build this database, and we made the database free and open. So we joked around of what we should call it, and I suggested initially just as a joke, oh, we should call it Freebase. which at the time was the slang for crack cocaine. And everybody told us we couldn't do that. So we did. And I was like, don't worry, someday we're just going to change the meaning of the word. And there'll be a generation that thinks Freebase means this. And sure enough, today I think if you search for Freebase in Google, you get like our Freebase before it comes up higher than crack cocaine. But